Hi, I'm Reed, this is Crowland Publishing, and today we are doing a lore video in which we take social customs, historical events, folklore, mythology, and we see what we can take that's gameable. Don't forget to give us a like before we begin, that really helps a lot. So, you're in a tavern by the fire when a mysterious man in a cloak approaches you and offers you the kind of job that only adventurers can do. Does that sound familiar? Probably does, right? That's because 1,000 D&D campaigns, 1,000,000 D&D campaigns have launched that way, and for very good reason. Inns and taverns and hostels have been central to European life for thousands of years. They were then, they are now, culturally, socially, and economically. You can safely eat, be warm, heal and sleep there in a world of dangers from snow to dragons. Commerce happens there, of course. You can meet employers, you can go shopping, adventurers love to go shopping. You can let your hair down and have fun, it's a place to carouse, chase romantic partners, to flash your cash, to get drunk and blow off steam after a difficult, dangerous time. One day we'll do an adventure of PTSD, but just take it as read that adventurers probably need a place to blow off steam after all that adventure. And by law, and by social convention, these are places of hospitality. Violence there isn't taboo, but it's absolutely frowned on. And that won't stop a murderer or an assassin, but it might keep swords in sheaths during a bar fight. So inns, taverns, hostels can and should be an interesting and important location in a game. A home base, a place of business, a place for you and your friends and your allies can consider safe. Often, guilds, primitive unions, would own their own inns as common spaces for people in that profession. So cutlers went to cutler pubs, seamstresses drank in seamstresses' pubs, things like that, and you could make professional contacts there and just hang out with your people. Inns are also great investments for adventurers that are flush with cash. There's a reason for the cliche of, it's a retired adventurer owns this inn. People always have to eat and sleep, why not own a hotel? So, because of this central, important role in people's lives, inns have entered the popular imagination, and they have a huge amount of folklore around them. Many, many old pubs are haunted. Many, many old pubs have a black legend that goes along with them. Someone was killed here, a gangster used to drink there. If you've spent any time in an old pub, you're gonna hear those stories. Now, the actual folklore of taverns is too much to go into, so I'm just gonna take five adventure ideas based around common rumors, mythology, folklore of inns from all around the world. Let's get to it. Number one, a local landlord. Everyone knows has a little brownie spirit that helped him out. It's a very common fae type. You can look it up on the old Wikipedia. They're the kind of fairies that mend shoes, fix your windows, clean your fireplace, that sort of stuff. And all you have to do is a little act of kindness. Leave them a bowl of cream. Leave them a nice little handwritten thank you note. And they will just help you out. But the landlord comes to the adventurers. My brownie is gone. I want him back. Can you help me? So, of course, the adventurers have to find out why did the brownie leave. The twist in the tale is, maybe the landlord wasn't telling the truth. Maybe the brownie's been killed with terrible repercussions. Maybe the brownie wasn't as nice as what it seemed. Number two, everyone knows the inn is haunted. Mary, she saw a woman walking down the hallways and you could see right through her. Perhaps even party members have seen it, but it's just a ghost. It's just a tavern ghost. No one's worried about it. But then the ghost starts attacking people and the adventurers are asked to intervene. What's caused the ghost to suddenly go bad? A killer is back in town, perhaps? Or maybe a dread necromancer has begun to work secretly in the community, disturbing the ether, and the once friendly tavern is now a haunted house. 3. Your tavern keeper, your friend. He loses the tavern in a game of cards and he comes to the party. I know you love this place as much as I do, and I'm desperate for your help. I'm pretty sure I was cheated. Maybe she was cheated. Now, the party has to go up against some pretty serious criminals. They want the pub for their crimes, either as a hideout, or maybe to do a bust out or something like that. Is the party ready to go up against a vicious and sadistic thieves' guild? This will have repercussions. Number 4. The Smuggler's Arms, just a local. It was originally built over smuggling tunnels leading down to the docks or to a river or whatever. And that was in your grandparents' time. That was, you know, 50 years ago. It's still a trapdoor. It's in the basement. It's nailed shut. But last night, something broke. broke it open from underneath, something that left eerie tracks in the tunnel, something that killed the tavern keeper. What is it? What was strong enough to punch through the solid wood? And what has provoked it after decades? Number 5. You visit a tavern in the woods after a successful adventure. You got a lot of money, but you got a lot of wounds. You need some time to heal up and get some spells back. The only problem is, the tavern keeper is in league with a local group of brigands, and when you're wounded and sleeping and resting, he puts the sign out, and suddenly a group of armed desperados is upon you in your sleep. Or worse, he is a serial killer who is prepared tunnels, secret entrances, all throughout the hotel. He disappears and appears as if by magic. Or even worse than that, he set this up as a way to collect the blood that keeps his terrible unlife going. Don't go into the basement. That is where he keeps his wives. So that's taverns. Individual taverns have loads and loads of interesting stories with them. Hauntings, crime, all that sort of stuff. When you read about them, it's just basically getting a fountain of ideas straight into your head. I hope this has been useful to you. If it has been, give us a like, give us a subscribe, tell your friends. I'm on Twitter, we've got a Facebook group, Crowland Publishing. See you next time. Bye now. Take care, because of this stupid-ass plague. Bye-bye.